So Vincent, when did you start shooting and why did you take this sport?
I started shooting when I was about 10 years old. I was big into baseball, big into sports, but this was one of the most challenging things I'd ever done. So when my dad kind of showed me the sport, I fell in love with it. And I started when I was 10 years old, started shooting international, the Olympic discipline when I was almost 12, and just kind of went from there. It was the most challenging thing I'd ever done before. So just that's what really drew me to it. It wasn't just the shooting sports itself, it was the challenge of always never knowing it, whether or not I'm gonna win or not, but always wanting to win.
And why do you shoot skeet?
For me, trap is a little too boring. It's a lot of standing around. I've always been kind of a guy that likes to be on the go and running around baseball, basketball, football, whatever it is.
What's the most challenging thing of skeet shooting?
The perfection aspect. And if I had to choose one, there's a lot of difficult things about skeet, about shooting in general. But looking at it, you know, you have the mechanics, you have the seeing the target clearly, you have all these other things that go in with it, but the true aspect of winning in skeet now has come to, if you miss a target, you're going to lose.
So when did shooting become a job for you? Because I think it started as a sport and now it's your full-time job, isn't it?
It did. When I was 16, I was recruited by the Army to come and shoot for the Army Marksmanship Unit. And that's really, I guess, when it became a job for me. But it was still, I was having so much fun doing it. I still have a lot of fun doing it. But now I'm out of the military and I have sponsors. So thankfully I'm with Beretta, with Noble Sport Italia, the ammunition company, and also just signed with Muller Chokes.
So how does it feel to compete here in Lonato, where all your sponsors are based?
It's very awesome. And this was the place where I won my first world championships.
That was probably your first big win. How does it feel to be back here in Lonato 10 years later?
This is my favorite place to shoot, especially being able to be in front of the sponsors. Some people feel more pressure being in front of them, but I just feel more of an opportunity to kind of let them see exactly who I am, what I do, and to kind of get to know me a little better.
Many things happened in these 10 years. Can you tell us about your sport career since your first world championship win in 2005 here in Lonato up to today, 2015?
Yes, things have changed drastically. Thanks. The first time I was here, I was 16 years old. I really had no idea what life was all about, but I just knew that I wanted to go out and win. And things are a lot different now. I've got two children, two little girls, and a wife, a house to support. A lot of things are different, but at the same time, it ends up being the same because I always want to win. When it boils down to it, that's what it's all about.
So you won the 2008 Olympic Games in Beijing and then the 2012 Games in London. What's your aim now?
2016. You know, since I made the Olympic team now and I'm already qualified, that's what it's all about. And this match is very important to me, yes, but in the grand scheme of things, there's only one match that I look for every 4 years, and it's the Olympics. So getting there now, everything is just a stepping stone.
What's special in the Olympics? I mean, why is that competition so different than anything else in the world?
It's the biggest, it's the hardest. You have the most people watching you, and that's what I like. I like the pressure being on me. And there's no pressure like the Olympics, that's for sure.
And how are you approaching to Rio now?
It's the exact same way. And after feeling how I felt this year, I feel very good out there right now. But I know now that everything is just looking forward to August 12th and 13th of next year. It's all about that. So whatever plans I can make to try to make myself peak and be the best that I can possibly be next year in August, that's what it's all about.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And I guess you won.
I doubt it. You had a lot of scores in there.